Flowers in God's Garden. Welcome back, family. 1 Corinthians 12, 14 through 28 reads, For the body is not one member, but many. If the foot shall say, Because I am not the hand, I am not of the body, is it therefore not of the body? And if the ear shall say, Because I am not the eye, I am not of the body, is it therefore not of the body? If the whole body were an eye, where were the hearing? If the whole were hearing, where were the smelling? But now hath God set the members, every one of them, in the body, as it hath pleased him. And if they were all one member, where were the body? But now are they many members, yet but one body. And the eye cannot say unto the hand, I have no need of thee, nor again the head to the feet, I have no need of you. Nay, much more, those members of the body which seem to be more feeble are necessary, and those members of the body which we think to be less honorable, upon these we bestow more abundant honor, and our uncomely parts have more abundant comeliness. For our comely parts have no need, but God hath tempered the body together, having given more abundant honor to that part which lacked, that there should be no schism in the body, but that the members should have the same care one for another. And whether one member suffer, all the members suffer with it, or one member be honored, all the members rejoice with it. Now ye are the body of Christ, and members in particular. And God hath set some in the church, first apostles, secondarily prophets, thirdly teachers, after that miracles, then gifts of healings, helps, governments, diversities of tongues. And Psalm 133:1 states, Behold, how good and how pleasant it is for the brethren to dwell together in unity. The previous scriptures reveal that God's people all have different talents and characters that are as the flowers in a garden. Some have healing virtues. Some give off a beautiful fragrance. We were not created to all look alike or be the same. The same can be said about different types of trees, each one having a different purpose. Some are used for the healing virtues of their bark. Others are fruit trees, each one producing their own unique and delicious kind of fruit. Yet, all are beneficial and work together for good. We, as God's children, are all uniquely made, and we all have an individual calling. None are considered better or superior to others. Therefore, none should try to make others as themselves. We are to be molded into God's image alone. We don't have to follow the crowd. It's okay to be different, so long as we are walking in God's Spirit and in the truth of His Word. Until next time, Maranatha.